Unlike most of you who've endured the trauma of a hurricane, my story goes back a few years. It's a story that some of you know, but for those of you who don't. In 1996, my wife and I, my first wife, were on a flight to Atlanta to visit her sister when I heard a loud popping sound. It was 2:10 in the afternoon. In the next 3 minutes, the plane banked and headed back toward Miami. But the cabin filled with smoke. 53 seconds later, the plane dropped 6,000 feet, crashed into the Everglades, and spread debris over a solid square mile. At this point, I really don't remember what happened. They tell me that they immediately called off the search for survivors, that it was impossible for anyone to live through the crash. They also tell me that 19 hours later, two rescuers pulled me from the water. Breathing, intact, alive. On this horrible day, over 100 people died. But not me. I was the sole survivor. And it took me a hell of a long time to figure out why. And I know a lot of you may be asking yourselves that question. But ultimately, it doesn't matter. Because I don't know why I lived. I don't know how I lived. But I do know that I emerged stronger and with a clearer purpose. And that's the promise that Hurricane Eve holds for all of you. Whether you believe it's God's gift or, no offense, Father, just sheer luck. You have all been given a second chance on life, and I encourage you not to squander it or dwell on why you were chosen. We make choices every day. Some that are clear, and some not so clear. But I believe that we have been chosen to rebuild this community as we rebuild ourselves. Some of us will rise to the challenge. Others won't. But we will all, ultimately, survive. Because we already have.